We may not see it directly, but bad audio sticks out like a sore thumb. You can have the best image quality in the world, but if your audio isn't crystal clear, your audience won't understand your message. Today, we're going to go over secondary audio recordings to make sure your sound is perfect every time. While many DSLRs have an audio in jack, the built-in audio recorder can leave your sound mangled. That annoying hiss can come even with high-end condenser microphones, just with a bad recorder like the one inside. Here in the studio, we use the TASCAM DR60 as our go-to secondary audio recorder. To use one of these devices, you're going to need four AA batteries, a Class 4 SD card, a microphone of your choice, and a pair of headphones to monitor your sound. If you're using a lapel mic, you'll also need one of the XLR to 3.5mm jack adapters to allow the microphone to connect to the recorder. With your equipment gathered, it's really important now that you do a test in the studio before actually going out into the field. Nothing is more stressful than coming back from a shoot and finding out that your audio is bad. With all the equipment gathered, it's time to do a quick test in the studio to make sure the levels and settings are correct. This is also a great time to check and make sure your batteries are charged. First, we're going to put the batteries inside of the recorder. By pulling off this tab, we reveal the battery compartment. We'll then put our four AA batteries in. Now that we can turn our recorder on, the first thing that we want to do is check the settings. We're going to hit the power button here on the right side of the recorder. Press and hold until the screen lights up. Now to go through our settings, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to hit Menu and Rec Mode. The Rec Mode should be set to Mono and the Source to Channel 1. We'll then go to Input Setting. As you can see, in the top left corner, it tells you what channel you're on, and then you have four settings. Gain should always be set to Mid. If it's on Low, your audio is going to be too quiet, and if it's on High, it's going to be way too loud. Limiter should be on Mono because we're recording in Mono. Low cut should be off and delay is set to reference. One thing to note is that if you do scroll down, you'll see how channel changed to 2. So make sure you're on the channel that you're editing on. We always record on channel 1 left or 1/L, so that's why we're going to be on channel 1. We'll hit the menu key to go back out and then scroll down using the scroll wheel to rec setting. Nothing should be changed here. But the format should be in WAV, and the sample should be in 44.1K. Size should then be set to 2 GB. Everything else should remain unchanged. We'll then hit the menu key again, and one more time to go back to the recording screen. Before we connect anything else, we want to note these knobs here. Each of them are your levels knobs to adjust the audio and sound. And so as you can see under 1/L on the left-hand side, we're going to make sure that's set to the middle. Also, in the notches below it, make sure that both of them are set to mic. On the left, it says line in, and that's from a camera, which we're not doing. Mic is from a microphone, and mic plus phantom is a special case when certain microphones need power from the recorder as well. In this case, because we're using a lapel microphone, we're not going to need that. We'll just leave it on mic, or the middle setting. We'll then take this time to insert our SD card. Now when we inserted our card, because we formatted it, it says format error. Are you sure? You're going to click the scroll wheel and it'll do its thing. The card is now ready to be used. With all of our settings in order, we can now test our setup. Now, we'll take our adapter and plug it into channel 1/L, which is the top one on the left side. We'll then take our lapel microphone and plug it into the adapter. Now it's time to go to your microphone and click it from off/smartphone to on. As you can see, when we turn it on, the levels bar on channel 1, as seen on the screen, now responds to the audio in the room, specifically me talking. This is how you know that the audio is working. When we're testing our levels, you'll notice that I've left a little bit of headroom where I can talk loud or snap or clap, and it doesn't quite peak all the time. This is good. This is why we have the levels in the middle. And that way, if there's unintentional rustling or the person you're interviewing or talking to talks really loudly, you don't have to worry about the audio peaking and cutting and getting bad quality sound. The next step is to take a pair of studio headphones and plug them into the monitoring part of the recorder. On the right side, you'll see a little box and then a jack that says phones. You'll plug these in here. One thing to note is there's a dial above that, and that's the microphone volume. So if you see your levels going up and down, but you can't hear anything on the microphone through the headphones, make sure that you check this dial and put it at least at 5, about a mid setting. Then when you put the headphones on, you should be able to hear your crisp, clean audio. A quick snap is usually a great way to tell if the audio is coming through. Then talking, and then introduce yourself like you would to the camera. This way you can hear your voice, other sounds in the room, and ambient noise. With this being said, our audio is now ready to use. We have great audio coming from the microphone and we can hear it on our headphones. And we can record it to our SD card. One quick thing to note though, is with these audio recorders, they don't start recording when you hit record, at least for the first time. When you hit record for the first time, the light will blink saying that it's ready to record. But as you'll notice, no numbers have started going up and down. So now we'll hit record again and the numbers will escalate, meaning that the recording has started. And the same thing is for stopping a recording. If you just hit record, it'll start blinking again and it will have paused the recording. This is really great if you just want to talk to an actor or an interviewee about something that they're doing in the shot or something that they're saying. You can then hit record again to continue the recording. If you want to stop the recording, you can hit the stop button. As you can see, the file name will have escalated and then you can start again. Another thing to note is to watch your battery in the top right corner. Unlike cameras, which save the last few images or video file right before their batteries die, the audio recorder does not, meaning that if you're on one bar, make sure to swap in new batteries. If you're doing a long recording and the batteries die, it will delete the last track that's in the recording and you'll be left with nothing. The audio should sound crisp and clear. You may now disconnect all of your devices and turn them off. Place them in your camera bag and wait for the shoot tomorrow. With all this in mind, you should be able to capture crisp, clear audio every time.